Robert McCloskey wrote and illustrated some of the most enduring children's books ever published. A natural storyteller, McCloskey was born in Hamilton, Ohio in 1914, attended public school and found himself interested in art, music, especially the harmonica, and tinkering with mechanical devices. After his training in Boston and New York City, he made two fortunate visits as an up-and-coming artist to Viking Junior Books, where the editor in charge urged him to develop a picture book story based on his hometown life in Hamilton. In 1940, McCloskey published Lentil. Soon after the book's publication, McCloskey moved back to Boston, where he found inspiration for his most famous work, Make Way for Ducklings, at the Boston Public Garden. During World War II, Bob married Peggy Durand, and in 1945, the couple had their first child, Sally. When Sally was 1 year old, the McCloskeys moved to Maine and bought an island. Blueberries for Sal was written and illustrated in Bob's island studio while awaiting the arrival of the family's second child. The book was meant to be a distraction for the real Sal, who was upset that she would no longer be an only child. Bob wrote more books about the family and Maine, including One Morning in Maine, Bert Dow, Deep Water Man, and Time of Wonder, Time of Wonder, which was written for his second daughter, Jane. Robert McCloskey was the first artist to win the Caldecott Medal twice. He was awarded a special citation at the Newbery Caldecott Banquet for the 50th anniversary of Make Way for Ducklings. And in 2000, he was named a living legend by the Library of Congress. He passed away 3 years later, but each of his 8 books is still in print today and continue to entertain, reassure, and surprise readers as they have for more than 60 years. We invite you to check out Blueberries for Sal at your local library and join us this fall for our world premiere musical based on this charming tale.